Hello viewers, welcome to Udayanath Autonomous College of Science and Technology. So you are watching our channel UN College Digital Classes, and I am Amita Patra, head of the department, Master of Commerce, Finance and Control. So we are discussing our paper, that is financial derivatives. And in our previous video we discussed about the future contracts, and also we discussed various functions of the future contract. So if you have gone through the video, you must have gone through a significant function of the future contract, that is hedging. So hedging is a very important, and it's a major function of the future contract. And in today's video we are going to learn in more detail about this future hedging. Today's learning objective is what is hedging and the multi-purpose concept of hedging. We will know about perfect hedging and short hedging, long hedging and cross hedging. All of us are very much aware of the fact that today's modern business is actually very complex, and a lot of factors are there which is influencing the profitability of the business. So there are a lot of factors like the interest rate, the commodity price, the stock price, the foreign exchange price. So like that, there are various external factors that is going to influence the business, which is very uncontrollable by the executives and the managers. So we can say that there is a very complex business environment in which today's modern business is running. In order to sustain in this complex business environment, or to run the business successfully, we need to overcome this risk factor, or we can say that we need to sift this risk. And the executives and the managers need to cover the uncertainty and risk that is there. So the important function of future market is to permit managers to reduce or control risk by transferring it to others who are willing to bear the risk. So this activity of transferring the risk, or we can say the avoiding the risk, or we can say that to sift the risk, that is what actually hedging is. So what hedging is? The hedging is the activity of trading futures with the objectives of reducing or controlling risk. So using a futures option to offset a natural risk exposure is hedging. And in a broader sense, if we will say that it is the act of protecting oneself against future losses. So this is what hedging is. So hedging is nothing but protecting ourselves or avoiding the uncertainty of risk, or we can say to ensure the risk that is there in the future, or we can say the protecting of future losses, that is what the hedging is. Okay, so this is what hedging is. We will be more clear that what hedging is with an example. Suppose there is a firm A which is manufacturing automobile cars of different gradations, and it is importing various parts for the manufacturing of car from suppose USA. So the firm A is expecting a price rise in the future, which is going to affect the manufacturing of car adversely. That is, it is going to affect the profit profile of the car. So in order to protect the costing of the car, or in order to protect the profit of the company will take a future contract on the price, on the exchange price. So this is what is the hedging is. So by this, it is taking a protective position, or it covers its risk of the future, that is the rise in the price. So if the price also rise in the future, it will make no loss. Now, that is how the hedging is working in future contracts. So we can take another example. Suppose there is a farmer who is going to yield a ton of save it in next month. But he is having a fear the product to be get sold in the future. So what he can do, that he can take a future contract of getting sold its wheat in the next month today. So that is what the future contract that it is taking in the anticipation of fall in the price of wheat is. So this is what the hedging is, or this is what is also an example of hedging or anticipating hedging is. So next we'll come to the multi-purpose concept of hedging. So actually what is there, that earlier hedging was taken to be only one kind, or we are saying that hedging is done for only one purpose, that is what, that is to avoid the price risk, or we can say the covering the price risk, and we call that hedging as routine or navy hedging. But there is a famous professor of America who is a professor of the Stanford University Food Research Institute. His name was Holber Working, and Holber Working put forward various notable articles on the hedging, and one of the important article that is by Holber Brook, that is the new concepts concerning futures markets and prices. And in that article, Working challenged this routine or navy hedging. So what he means to say, that this is not the only purpose, or this is not the only thing for which the hedging is used by the future contracts, but there are some other factors, or there are some other purposes of for which also we use hedging. So that all the other factors according to Working can be the carrying cost, it can be the anticipatory hedging, it can be operating hedging, or it can be the selective hedging also. So like that, there are multiple purpose of hedging that is done, or that is put forward by Working in his article, and he is saying that the hedging is not used for the single purpose, rather it is used for a various for a multiple purpose. So the navy hedging, which we consider that trader always hedge all his transactions purely for covering all the price risk. But H. Working proposed multi-purpose concept of hedging, which is widely accepted. Now we will see what this multi-purpose concept of hedging is. So the multi-purpose hedging is having various purposes, as we have said. So it has carrying charge hedging. So according to this approach, the stochast watch the price spread between the spot and future prices, and if the spread covers even carrying costs, then the stochast buy ready stocks. So by carrying charge hedging, what H. Working is trying to say, that actually it is not primarily whether to hedge or not, rather whether to stock or not, that is what he is saying. So this is what the carrying charge hedging is. So next we have operational hedging. And according to this view, hedgers use the futures market for their operations and use the same as substitute for cash or forward transactions. So they think the futures markets are more liquid and have lower difference between the bid and ask prices. So that is what the operational hedging is, or the purpose of hedging is operational. Next we have selective, or we are saying discretionary hedging. So what this selective or discretionary hedging is, this concept says that the traders protect themselves in selected occasions and not always. Hedging is used selectively at the time of adverse price movement. So by selective hedging, what Working is trying to say, that it is not always that the hedgers go for protecting themselves or it is not always that the hedgers are taking the hedging positions or they are taking the future contracts. There are selective options or say selective situations where the traders go for hedging, not always. This is what the selective or discretionary hedging is. Next, we are having anticipatory hedging. So, by anticipatory hedging, we are saying that this is done in anticipation of subsequent sale or purchase. So, it is what? It is the anticipation of the risk that we are having. So, for example, suppose there is a farmer who is expecting a yield in his field and he anticipate a fall in price. So, in the anticipation of fall, he go for a selling of that particular commodity in the future market, or we can say there is a manufacturer or a miller who want the millets or we can say the pulses, and he go for buying or purchasing of that particular commodity in the anticipation of a hike in the price or up in the price. So that this is what the anticipation hedging is. So here there is a anticipation of loss in the future, which has been covered by the hedge position. So these are the multi-purpose hedgings are, which is put forward by working. So next we'll come to a term that is perfect hedging. So what do I mean by perfect? So if we are saying that something is perfect, that means what? That something which is very much accurate, or we can saying that something which is doing what it means to do, that is what perfect means. Suppose we'll say someone is perfect, that means how it should be, it is. So if you are saying it is a perfect match for say, so the couple are very much complementary to each other, or they look good together, so that is what we are saying the perfect match. So like that, the very word perfect means which is meeting that particular concept or that particular thing for which it is meant to be. So by perfect hedging, what we mean by hedging, as we know, that it is something of covering the risk or protecting the risk or avoiding the risk. So by perfect hedge, what we mean, it is the position what it is said that where we are completely eliminating the risk. So that is what the perfect hedging is. And what it is saying, the use of futures position to reduce completely business risk is called the perfect hedge. So that we can be clear with an example, like suppose a jewelry firm X has an inventory of 200 kgs of gold and it intended to sell it in October. So current price of gold is 38,000 rupees per kg and the firm is anticipating a fall in the price. So to hedge against this possibility, the firm enters into 200 kg of short position at a future price of rupees 39,000 per kg. So if the future price of gold do fall, then the firm protects itself by the future position. So this is the example of a perfect hedge, is that we are anticipating a downfall, or we can say that we are anticipating a fall in the price. By taking the future contract, we can protect the risk that is there of the falling price of gold. So this is an example of perfect hedge. So now we will see how a perfect hedge works. So let us assume that T is the present period and capital T is the date in October, or we can say the maturity date on which we are going to purchase the gold. QT is the quantity of gold. PT is the price at the time of maturity. FTT is the future price at the time of maturity. And FTT is the futures price at the present time. So the net cost to the manufacturer is the price of gold less the profit on the futures positions. Like this will be the scenario. So the scenario is PT, the gold cost is QTPT, the futures profit is QT, it is FTT minus FTT, and QT, that is PTT minus FTT, and the net silver cost is QTFTT. So here PT is equal to FTT because delivery date converse and net gold cost is equal to gold cost minus futures profit. So QT FTT is equal to QT PT minus QT PT minus FTT. So it is observed that the above hedge meets all the requirement of a perfect hedge. The manufacturer know that the gold cost at the time T, that is the future time, will be QTPT, which is linear function of the gold price, because every rupee change in the gold price will change QTPT by QT. So by entering into the long futures at the present time, that is T, the manufacturer established that this cost at time T will be QT FTT. He thus locks in today's future price for his gold purchase. This is how we are going to see that how the perfect hedge is working. So next we will discuss short hedge. So what a short hedge is, it is the position that is taken by the trader in the future contract as a short position, or we can say that a short position, or we can say that a short hedge is a hedge that involves short position in the future contracts. So the main objective is to protect the value of cash position against a decline in cash price. Short hedge is appropriate when the hedger already owns an asset. So what a short hedge is, as we know and we have discussed about the short position in the financial derivative. So what a short position, what we have discussed, that is it is the position of selling, or it is a sell position. So what when a trader goes for short hedging, that when he is anticipating a decline in the price, he own a particular asset or commodity and he anticipate or he expect that there will be a decline in price, so he go for a future contract, and that position of selling that it is taking is known as the short hedge. So another is the long hedge. So it is just the opposite of the long of the short hedge. So a long hedge is a hedge that involves long position in the future contracts, and the main objective is to protect against a price increase in an underlying asset. So it is appropriate when a firm has to purchase a certain asset in future and wants to lock in a price now. So what a long hedge is, or what we call as being long, is that this is the position we have already know that we are taking a long position. So when we are taking a long position means what? We are expecting that the price is going to high or the price is going to up in the future, and we are planning to buy it in the future to make profit out of it or to make gain out of it. So that is what the long hedge is. So this is just the opposite of the short hedge. There is another concept in hedge, or there is another hedge which we say, that is cross hedge. So as we have discussed earlier, there is a position of short hedge or there is a position of long hedge. So in these positions, what we are expecting or anticipating, that there might be rise in the price or there might be fall in the price. So we are accordingly taking the position in the future contracts. But there might be some situations where there is mismatch of assets or mismatch of maturity date. So at that position or that situations, we go for cross hedge. So what a cross hedge is? A cross hedge is a hedge in which the characteristics of the spot and futures positions do not match perfectly. The situations like maturity mismatch, asset mismatch, etc., makes the hedge a cross hedge. So this mismatch situations which make the hedge a cross hedge can be the hedging horizon may not match the futures expiration date, the quantity to be hedged may not match with the quantity of the futures contract, the physical features of the asset to be hedged may differ from the futures contract asset. So this is what is the cross hedge is. So this is what we have to discuss for today. So in today's video, we have discussed that what a hedging is, what is a perfect hedge, what are the multiple purpose of hedging, and we discuss what is a short hedge, what is a long hedge, and what is a cross hedge. So hope we people have understood. So in our further classes, we'll discuss more. Thank you.